everyone, I'm Lily. Happy Water Quality Week. As part of Water Quality Month, we're celebrating Water Quality Week in the state of Indiana. This week...
Did you know Indiana is connected to two Great Lakes? Not only do we have a Lake Michigan watershed, but the Maumee River is also connected to Lake Erie. This is another one of our shared watersheds. I'm here in the northeastern corner of Indiana by the Maumee River. The Maumee River flows all the way from Fort Wayne to Toledo.
The Maumee watershed shares similar impairment issues to other watersheds in the state of Indiana, but one of the impairment issues that we haven't talked about yet is E. coli. Today we're going to talk about poop. E. coli are bacteria that come from mammal feces. If you remember, a watershed is an area of land that collects water for a given water body. All farms are in a watershed. And that means that all poop from those farms is also in that watershed. Looking at this chart from IDEM, we can see that livestock and animal feeding operations, concentrated animal feeding operations, CAFOs, and other animal agriculture impair almost 20,000 stream and river miles in Indiana. I'm also going to point out that failing septic and untreated sewage accounts for a little over 8,000 miles. Yeah, that means E. coli is washing into our water sources for drinking water, swimming, recreation, and other purposes. The EPA allows up to 5% concentration of E. coli to account for natural environmental factors. We can't make every animal stop pooping. But impaired waters have a higher concentration, and some strands of E. coli can cause serious illness. For the protection of our public health, treating wastewater from livestock areas would help prevent the spread of diseases caused by E. coli.